The flagging off ceremony was conducted by David Katende, the Assistant General Secretary of NCS, alongside Annette Nakamia, the chairperson of the Uganda Badminton Association, at the NCS headquarters in Lugogo. During the event, Katende urged the players to give their utmost effort in order to secure qualification for the 2024 Paralympic Games in Paris, France, while handing over the flag.
Government, we have at the moment, this being an Olympic year, we are prioritizing three major sports events, that is the Olympics, Paralympics, and All Africa Games. And therefore, the funding prioritization is being geared towards the qualifier pathways to these games. So as this team is moving to Thailand, we are all aware that this is one of their last leg to qualify for Paris, and we want to give them an opportunity to see whether we can have some of them, all of them, qualifying to participate in the Paralympics. Besides that, for us, we have that commitment for the all other athletes and sportspersons who are yet to qualify, that we shall give them opportunities, and this will depend on also the resources we have. But as government, we want to see as many of our people qualifying for the Olympic Games, because we know what it means. The Olympics and Paralympics are the epitome of all sports events.
The Parabadminton World Championships serve as the final qualifying event for the Paralympics, and players are determined to solidify and enhance their current rankings. Annette Nakamia, the chairperson of the Uganda Badminton Association, expresses confidence that this time they will qualify at least five athletes for the 2024 Paralympic Games.
The seven that are going to represent us are top in their categories across the continent. So what we need them to do is to come back from Thailand as the top of the continent, but also they need to add on the points from what they have right now, what they last got from Egypt last month. They need to add on the points, such that at the end of this tournament, when the list is brought out, they need to be able to be first of all top of the continent, but also having added more points for them to be able to be within the qualification bracket.
Among the players with strong chances of qualifying are Sarah Naziwa, Ali Chibirango, Rose Nasereko, and Sumin Mutesi, all of whom hold the top ranking in their respective categories.
For this tournament, it is for championships. They just call you to participate, which is different from the last tournament. Last tournament, you apply, you go. If they accept you, you go. But this tournament is BWF to call you. So they call for champions in different countries. So it's going to be hard this time around, but I've worked on my weaknesses. I promise to give the best I can.
In Africa, I'm at 2 right now. I slipped a bit, and I'm at 22, road to Paris, hoping by the time I come back, I'm back to my normal, above the rank, which is, I think, should be 16, 1 to 16, which is kind of hard, but going for the world ranking, it's a double score, and adding to my performance, that will mean extra scores, so that means I'll have to put a lot to see that I get the ranking I need to get the automatic qualification.
The team, comprised of 7 members, consisting of 5 women and 2 men, is set to travel for the Parabadminton World Championships, which are set to take place from February 20th to 25th in Pattaya, Thailand.